You don't mind?
Mine? I hope you do it again. You are a criminal. Stupid criminal.
Dirty bitch! You swine! You fiend!
You asking for
more, you stupid cow?
Let's not spoil it, please.
I didn't come here to sit down or calm down. I want to know the truth about you and Anne.
How?
Thank you. You've just answered my question.
Hey, Phyllis, you see anything of Hannah on your way back?
Yeah, she's all right. I saw what's left of her. And what do you mean? I mean, someone's given her a bashing, and if you ask me, she got what she deserved.
Since when?
I don't understand. You were wanting to help her before.
What? Look, I don't give a stuff about that dumb wog. The sooner they ship her out of here, the better.
Am I sent away?
Not until you're well. The doctor thinks that might be as long as 2 weeks.
Yes. I have pain all over my body. Such a pain. But now I'm safe. For 2 weeks I'm safe.
Oh, look, who gives a stuff if she got bashed up? She's only a dumb crab. Anybody thinks she's the Queen of England the way you lot are carrying on?
Shut your mouth, Phyllis. That's a rotten thing to say.
Hey, steady on. I didn't do it, you know.
Well, who did?
I'll give you 3 guesses.
Got something to tell us, Keen?
About what?
Didn't know you cared, Desmond. Hannah was bashed. You?
No.
Your heavies.
Come to think of it, they did mention something about that. Get a little carried away, did they?
Oh, you're going to get carried away one day, Keen. Did you get your kicks, did you? Bashing up a scared refugee.
She asked for it, according to Luke.
A tripe.
I'm telling you, she just wouldn't let up. It's like she wanted them to bash her.
Well, she's pretty desperate to stay here.
Oh, yeah, but that desperate?
Looks like the girls did you all a favour. Reckon you owe us one, Desmond.
Oh, I owe you one, all right, Keen. And I won't forget it.
Desmond, if you can tear yourself away from Keane, Mrs. O'Regan would like some help in the kitchen.
You'll keep
any time.
Now, Desmond!
Welcome back to the real world, Phil. Just about to take you off the payroll.
What are you talking about?
Never mind. I'm going to do a little job on the goodies. They're kind enough to send me on that little trip. Reckon I ought to pay them back. And you are going to help me.
Look, all I want to do is talk to her. This stuff is news. You don't seem to understand.
Now, Mr. Lockhart, you don't seem to understand. You cannot see Hannah Geldschmidt, and that is final.
Lady, if I have to stay here all day, I will. Believe me,
I... Good morning, Mrs. Davidson.
Good morning, Miss Ferguson. Is Mrs. Reynolds in?
She is. She's in the staff room. I could page her for you.
No, I'd rather you just get her for me. I don't want the women to know I'm here. But attend to your visitor first, of course.
Oh, he's not exactly a visitor. In fact, he's a reporter from the Dispatch, the one who wrote the article on Hannah Geldschmidt.
Is he indeed? Mm. Well, in that case, I have a few things to discuss with him. Mr. Lockhart, isn't it?
You know me.
Oh, yes. Very well. I'm Erica Davidson from the Department of Corrective Services.
Well, this is quite a break. I've got a few things to ask you.
Really? I have one or two things to ask you.
So it's all right for me to go, then?
I don't see why not. The department stops us from doing anything officially, but that doesn't mean we can't visit the hospital in our own time.
Oh, well, I'll go tonight after work. I don't know what help I'll be, but a few kind words might make a difference.
I'm sure they will. Now, look, I know I don't have to say this, but I'd hate to see you get too deeply involved. Dr. Edmund seems to think that this...
No, of course not. I better get back.
Meg, there's something wrong.
Why should there be?
Well, I know about you and Dr. Edmund. Maybe it's none of my business, but...
You know what?
Well, he did. He said you didn't see eye to eye on the treatment of the women.
Oh, I see.
I know how close you are to the women, Meg. If anyone said anything to you...
No, they haven't. Perhaps I don't know enough about Dr. Edmund's field to pass judgment. He may be a genius for all I know.
Close enough to it, anyway.
He's extremely dedicated to his work.
Yeah, I'm sure he is. Well, perhaps it's just his manner. Oh, I don't know. I'd really rather not talk about it. I'm on dining room duty. I better go.
I'll be there in just a moment. Governor, Mrs. Davidson is here to see you.
Oh, dear. I suppose the department's looking for blood because of that newspaper article.
Yes, well, this may not help matters much, but she has a reporter with her. A very pushy type. In fact, the one who wrote the article.
Terrific.
Jude, Frieda slipped me this. She said Maura told her to pass it on. Don't let the food see.
Well, what do you know? There is a Father Christmas after all.
Come on, Jude, what's cooking?
They got Hannah's story to the press.
That means she won't have to go back?
Well, I don't know, but there are petitions being signed all over the country to keep her here. Myra said we'll be next.
I mean, we're going to start up a petition.
You bet we are, Annie.
Good idea, Jude. When do we start?
Well, something bothering you, Rip?
Just wondering how Dumbo there's going to sign it.
Oh, geez, Rip, can't you say something nice, you know, just for a change?
Sure. I really like the way you held me down and fed me the dope case, okay? Petition's my thumb.
You know, Reb, I would have thought you would have been one of the first ones to sign that petition, seeing that you were the one that put Hannah in hospital.
Yeah, well, you thought wrong. Desmond wants me to sign that. She can ask me herself. Nicely.
Yeah, well, I reckon everybody ought to sign. What about you, Phyllis?
Phyllis is with me and she's not signing.
Yeah, that's right. We don't need them anyway, do we?
Of course we don't. We just get as many names as we can get and then send it off to the dispatch of the Department of Immigration.
Bryant.
Yeah?
What have you got in your pocket, Bryant?
I don't suppose you'd believe me if I said it was a doggy bag.
In that case, you better hand it over. We don't do takeaways.
Come on, Miss Ferguson. We're trying to help Anna.
Geldschmidt is an illegal immigrant and she will go back to where she came from.
Well, what are we going to do now, Jude?
We are going to get that petition organized pronto. We have one chance to help Hannah. I'm not going to let the freak screw it up for us. And I'll tell you one thing. Everybody is going to sign that petition. And I mean everybody.
All I'm saying is that our switchboard was jammed with people who thought they might be related to Hannah. I just think the woman has a right to know, don't you?
Yes, Mr. Lockhart. But what you must understand is it's out of our jurisdiction. What I can tell you is that with the help of the West German consulate, there will be an appeal made for residency within the next couple of days.
Well, it's great. I'll get on to it. See what the paper can do to help. This isn't just a story to me, ladies. I really care about Hannah Geldschmidt. And somebody in here obviously feels the same, or they wouldn't have given me the story in the first place.
Somebody from Wentworth?
Oh, yes. At least she said she was when she phoned.
And did she say who she was?
No. To tell you the truth, the name didn't seem important. Not when I heard how hot the story was.
Well, we'll just have to make some inquiries and find out who made the call. Won't we, Mrs. Reynolds?
Yes, of course.
Okay, now we agree we're all on the same side. Do I get to see Hannah?
I'm sorry, Mr. Lockhart. Really, I am. But it's quite out of the question.
Oh, why'd you let me do it?
I couldn't stop you. Anyone would think you hadn't eaten in a month.
Well, apart from Mrs. O'Regan's cooking her mine, I haven't. Where do you think I'm hanging around you?
Oh, I'll get you.
Kiss better than Mrs. O'Regan. Ah, now you look better.
Oh, how did I look before?
Beautiful. A bit worried about something, aren't you?
How did you know that?
Oh, I'm a clever little bugger. You want to talk about it?
Oh, I suppose I'm just being silly, really, but George does look run down, doesn't he? I mean, did you see him before we left?
Yeah, he was lugging bundles of papers around. Would have knocked the youngster in.
That's just my point. He's not a youngster anymore. Honestly, Rick, I'm all he's got. What's he going to do when I go away and do my home economics course? I mean, he'll just run himself into the ground.
No, he won't. I'll keep an eye on him. Keep me from missing you.
Thanks, Rick. Maybe you could just talk to him. Get him to relax a bit.
Relax.
And so, in the name of compassion and humanity, we, the undersigned, ask that Hannah Geldschmidt be granted permanent residency in Australia. What do you think?
Good one, Jude. Nobody could have done no better. Now, where do I sign?
Just there, top of the list.
No X's count.
Oh, beauty. Never had to sign a petition before.
How about you, Red? Come on, I know you think you have an axe to
grind. I don't think, Brian. I know. Now, come along, Phyllis. Doc Edmonds wouldn't like it if he thought you was being stroppy.
Listen, I've not seen the doc anymore, and that means no more fags and no more bludgeons. So why should I start a stupid bloody thing?
Because if you don't, Hannah might have to go back to Germany, and that doesn't seem very fair to me. In fact, I'm getting mad just thinking about it.
Give us the bloody thing, anything to shut you up.
Gutless wonder.
Thank you very much.
What do you got there, Brian? Your laundry list?
It's nothing really, Miss Ferguson.
Well, then if it's nothing, you might just as well give it to me.
Come on, it's a petition to help Hannah. We're not doing any harm.
You're not doing any work either. Now, come on, hand it over.
Come on, Miss Ferguson, we're not breaking any rules.
Now, Brian.
Problems?
Yeah. Brian's just being a little secretive today, that's all.
It's nothing really. It's just that we've got a petition here to help Hannah. I was showing it to Miss Ferguson. I thought maybe you would sign it.
Hmm. I think it's a marvellous idea. As a matter of fact, we'll take it to Mrs. Reynolds and see if she'd like to sign it as well. She wants to see you.
Is it about Hannah? Is she okay?
Yes, she's going to be fine, so there's no need to worry. Have you finished with that, Miss Ferguson?
Thank you.
Come on.
All right. How about you good Samaritans get on with the work you're being paid to do?
Yes, Miss Ferguson.
I think I can promise you there won't be any repercussions, Judy, but Mrs. Davidson needs a name. Otherwise, the department will be down on all our necks.
Mrs. Reynolds, I know that newspaper article was just what Hannah needed. But if you think I'm responsible for it, you're wrong. I only wish I was.
You mean you didn't make another call? But I thought maybe one of the other women
Look,
may have tried.
If one of the other women had done it, I would have heard about it by now.
Well, we're back to square one. I'll just have to tell Mrs. Davidson we couldn't find the culprit. The damage has been done now anyway.
Yeah. Look, maybe we can help by getting a petition together. I was wondering, I mean, well, Mrs. Morris
is... Well, I've already signed, and I'm sure some of the other officers would like to.
Good. Makes a change for us all to be on the same side, doesn't it?
Yeah. You know, I wish I knew who made that phone call. Then I'd know who to thank.
Well, I think it's ridiculous to veto the women's phone calls one minute and then give them permission to circulate a petition the next.
Now the article's been printed and the story's become public, the women have every right to their opinions.
Oh, maybe so. It still doesn't give Mrs. Morris the right to undermine me in front of the women.
Oh, I did not. I simply walked in and found you holding the petition. Nothing was said. Now, I signed that petition because I believe in it. And Joyce and Colleen and Joanne are going to do the same.
And I already have.
Well, I hope no one expects me to sign it.
That's up to you. No one's forcing you. You've got a choice. And that's the whole point, isn't it? The women choose to help Geldschmidt. Meg chooses to support them.
Yeah, and what about the department? They'll have to know.
Oh, well, I dare say you'll tell them if nobody else does.
Well, I think the minister should be informed.
Well, I think our news hound has finally gone away happy.
Good. Well, I think Miss Ferguson has something she'd like to tell you.
Yes, Miss Ferguson.
Yes, it seems that the women are getting up a petition to plead for Geldschmidt.
Are they? Well, it's within their rights to protest. Who knows, it may even do some good.
But the department have to...
The department won't approve of it. Officially, that is. But we are quite human, despite the bureaucracy. We all know that poor woman deserves all the help she can get. I certainly wouldn't want to send her back. Would you?
No, of course not.
Try it now.
Okay, boss. Whatever you say.
With the distributor.
Cordon Blue Cook, A-grade mechanic.
You're sending me up.
Would I do that?
Yes.
Oh, look, I am very impressed.
Yeah, well, I don't promise it'll last. Might be a good idea to get it to a garage.
Yeah, right. Meanwhile, how is your carpentry? Because I've got a window that won't open,
Go.
The roof leaks,
Go.
And the plumbing in the Go. Bathroom, my God.
Feel real good, you know, me signing that piece of paper could make all the difference to Hannah, I do.
Yes, I'm sure it will.
Hey, do you reckon Mrs. M will really get the screws to sign?
Well, she said she would.
Sure she didn't. Screws never lie, do they, Jude?
Oh.
Must be taking a zombie lesson from Park.
Oh, give it a rest, Keen. I don't like it.
Oh, I don't like being a zombie.
too bad, Parker. It's not your fault. You were just washing your face when the toilet seat fell on your brain.
A good one, Reb. I wish I'd said it.
You probably will.
Now listen, why don't you two just shut up? At least we have the courage of our convictions.
Oh, yeah. Now, which conviction is that? The one for robbery or murder?
Parker, you've got a visitor.
Hey, I only had one a couple of days ago.
Yeah, and you got another one today, the same one. You've been holding out on us, Parker. He's very eager.
What do you know? Cass has got a boyfriend.
But he had to leave his CNI dog outside.
I'll give it a rest. He's not a boyfriend, he's just a mate.
And whatever he is, I suggest you hurry up. He may have all day. I haven't.
And there was this rigidige squire they brought all the way up from England. I tell you, I was so nervous, my mouth was as dry as anything. Nah. Well, then he looks at Lucy, and she sort of snuffles his hair.
Ah, she used to do that when she was a nipper, remember?
Yeah.
Ah.
Well, then he says to me, in one of them real posh voices, he says, "Fine example of a saddleback brooding sow. Absolutely first class."
Oh, you mean you won?
Well, we won, Kaz.
Oh, gee.
If it hadn't been for you, she wouldn't have made it past the suckling stage. That's why I want you to have this. I reckon it should be yours anyhow.
Oh, Charlie, no, I couldn't. You waited years for this.
But I want you to, Kaz. Think of it.
Oh.
Just a minute.
Please.
No passing goods without a security check.
Security? Oh, look, I didn't know the rules. I'm sorry. It's just a ribbon.
It still has to be checked. You could be trying to pass drugs.
Drugs?
Stress.
No, look, Miss Ferguson, it's just a ribbon. It's a present for me.
Yeah, I can see that.
There you go. I reckon 20 blue ribbons wouldn't be good enough for you.
Yeah, and then it'll make me feel really useless. She sends me to sit in the car while she fixes the damn thing.
I thought you'd have figured it out by now, Rick. She's a bossy little piece of time.
Oh, yeah. Terrific. Both of you ganging up against me now. And look at you. You look like you're about to drop. I think you should spend a few days in bed, Pop.
See what I mean, Ricky? I told you, isn't she bossy? Look, I've got the flu, Rachel, not some dreaded disease. I'll be quite all right now. Excuse me.
Will you talk to him? This place is too much. He needs to take it easy.
He's got a point, George. The hours are long. What time do you finish tonight? 8 o'clock?
Yes, 9 by the time we get home.
Could get someone in to give you a hand, you know.
I could, but I don't want to. I like working, Rick, and I don't get tired. I'll be all right in a few days, you'll see.
Fine. Well, I better get going. I'm not going to get to the garage. Oh, I have got a call back later and give you a lift home.
Thanks, it'll be marvellous. I'll fix us some supper.
Oh, hang on, I'm still getting over lunch.
Thanks for trying.
It's all right. See you later.
Gorgeous. Simply gorgeous.
Now, what do you reckon about that? Isn't that beautiful?
Fantastic, Cass. Your Charlie must be quite a fella.
Yep.
Yeah, well, at least he knows a pig when he sees one.
Oh, very bored with you, weasel.
Hey, do you reckon Charlie will come to the family day, Renault promises?
Oh, yeah, and if he does, he's going to want to meet everybody. Well, all me mates, said he.
Now, look, you lot. Your crap mate's on television. But Ronnie, cut the piano.
The Department of Immigration reports over 10,000 protesters have already phoned or delivered petitions requesting Hannah Geldschmidt be granted immediate residency. Credit must be given to the inmates of Wentworth Detention Centre.
Oh, hey, that's us, proletarians!
Shut up, Drongo!
And what do you think? Our switchboard will be open for the next 2 hours. You can ring and register your vote on our phone poll. These are the numbers on your screen right now.
Oh, Ma, you reckon we could phone up?
Oh, I doubt it, love. Still, we've done something useful.
Yeah, and we hardly had anything to do with it.
Still, the main thing is somebody got that call through to the press.
Yeah. You know, Ma, it's a shame you couldn't get Reb to sign that petition.
Still, she doesn't do anything unless she really wants to.
Well, Myra, where are you going?
I'm going to ask someone for a favour. Nicely.
Parker, quite the little social butterfly these days, aren't we? This was handed in at reception a few minutes ago.
Well, from Charlie, Miss Ferguson.
Well, yeah, unless you've got another admirer we don't know about.
And Miss Ferguson, they're doing a phone poll on the television to see whether Hannah should stay in the country or not. I don't suppose we could ring in and vote.
You're quite right, Brian. I don't suppose you could.
Well, well. It isn't the big boss herself. Sit down.
Or better still, rack off.
I'm not here to fight with you, Keane.
Oh, bet you're not. You haven't got any drugs to shove down my
neck. You brought him into the jail, remember? But that's not why I'm here. I owe you for bashing Hannah. Now you can play it the hard way or the easy way.
Ooh, get a choice, do I?
Phyllis said you'd sign the petition if I asked nicely.
Yeah, didn't I?
Set up. I must be slowing down in my old age. Now, as I say, you can play it two ways. It's up to you.
Oh, I think you won a heart there.
I'm surprised he doesn't run a mile away. You carry on.
Oh, don't be stupid. He knows a good thing when he sees it. Well, go on. Off you go.
Don't be silly. I'll wait for you.
I'll be a few minutes yet. I've got to lock up the back. Go on. Off you go.
Okay, but hurry up.
I will.
Hi.
Hi.
Guess what?
It was the distributor, right?
Right. Maybe I should keep you around. Even if it is just to check on the car. Look out, mate!
Sir?
Yeah, she's hanging in there.
Sorry to put you both through all those questions.
Part of the job. What about him?
Well, he gave us a hard time with a breathalyzer. I'm not surprised. 0.15. He's sobering up fast now, though. I'd better get into the station. Excuse me.
Right.
A couple of lousy beers, that's all I had, right? That silly old bugger, he just walked right out in front of me. There was nothing I could do.
You can explain at the station.
Station? What station? I don't have to go anywhere. I know me
rights. Mr. Priest, we need a written statement. You understand? No, we can't do that here in the street.
I suppose not. I want to call me solicitor, right?
I'll ring the number for you personally now. Go with Constable Miles. Come on.
This is going to be very sore tomorrow.
Yeah. Well, it could have been worse.
I don't know. I think you must be very careful in future. She's out for blood.
Just have to keep our eyes and ears open.
Hey, Jude, Clark, it's about Hannah.
Our phone poll showed an overwhelming 3-1 majority in favour of
Isn't that fantastic?
Oh, I don't reckon I'll send her back now, do you?
Oh, no way.
Coming up next.
Why don't you turn this rubbish off? Sick to death of hearing about Geldschmidt. You take a lot of convincing, don't you,
Keith? Yeah, I suppose I do.
Oh, what's this?
Oh, just a friendly...
No. Just spare me the stories. I think I know them all by heart. Come on, back to your cells.
Oh, but
now, Mrs. Powell.
No. 5 minutes ago. Come on, ladies.
Mrs. Powell, please. Can't we watch this program? It's about Hannah. What with the newspapers being censored, we don't know what's going on.
Well, it's never stopped you in the past, has it? Besides, you always seem better informed than the media.
Look, Mrs. Powell, Hannah is our friend. We've got a right to know how things are shaping up for her.
Yeah, all right. I'll ask Mrs. Reynolds, see if you can have the newspapers untouched tomorrow.
Thanks.
Please, get out. Come on.
I reckon Pieface has gone soft in her old age.
Don't bet on it.
How much longer do we have to wait?
We haven't been here long. How about friends?
Relatives? No, there's nobody. Nobody that matters. That's why we were so close.
He's a fighter.
Miss Milton?
Is he all right?
He's on his way down to surgery now. He has a ruptured spleen, and we think one lung is perforated, apart from several fractures. Look, I won't pretend it's not serious, but his heart seems strong enough so there's absolutely no reason why he shouldn't recover.
When will we know something for certain?
Well, he'll be in theatre for several hours. After that, he'll go to intensive care.
Can I see him?
No, I'm sorry. But look, why don't you go home and get some sleep? It will be better for both of you if you wait until the morning.
Makes sense. Really?
Yes. I suppose so.
Good. We have your number. I'll get someone to call you just as soon as we have some news.
He'll make it. I know he'll make it. But I'm so scared, Rick.
Just keep believing. That's all we can do. Just keep believing.
And she said she's not going to open it because it might be bad news.
Yeah, well, why would he be writing to me when he's only just seen me, Jude? I reckon it's got to be bad news.
Oh, heavens, it might be a billet doux.
A what?
A love letter. A romantic.
A love letter? Oh, no, it wouldn't be.
Well, you're never going to find out until you open it, you know.
Oh, yeah, I suppose you're right. Oh, gee. Now, you two won't laugh at me, will you?
Of course we won't.
Okay, here you go.
Well, aren't you going to read it out loud?
Oh, come on, honey. You don't want people reading out your love letters.
Of course I do. What's the point in being in love if you can't tell anyone about it?
Well, hey, I reckon you two were right after all. What do you know?
I knew it. I just knew
it. Well, congratulations, kid. Looks like you've got yourself a fella, huh?
Yeah, Charlie says he wrote this down because he was a bit scared of how I'd take it, you know. Hey, hang on a bit. I'll find this bit here. He says, all day long, especially when I'm out riding through the bush, I can't get you out of my mind.
How romantic.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. And he says he wanted to win that ribbon for me because I deserve it and it would show me how he really feels. Oh, listen to this bit. He said, I always remember your hair, all shiny and smelling like a flowering gum.
Looks as though your Charlie has got away with words.
Yeah. And he signs it, your respectful admirer. Yeah. Gee, you always did have a touch of class, Charlie.
Yeah, and good taste, too.
Oh, it's going to be a wedding just like Petra and Scott's, and I'm going to make the wedding cake. I just wish Lizzie could be here.
Oh, you know, hang on a minute, Pixie. I just got this letter.
But he loves you, your respectful admirer. Don't you love him, too?
Oh, I don't know. I mean, I never got a love letter before. Don't know how I feel. Well, I mean, I'm real glad about it, you know, but... Geez, what am I going to say to him?
Yeah, that's fine. Thanks a lot. It's not much consolation, but they've charged the driver with over 0.05 and culpable driving. Look, can I fix you something to eat?
No, thank you, no. I couldn't eat. I'm too tired.
Why don't you get yourself to bed? I can stay on
it's
the couch
okay,
here.
It's okay, really. I'll be fine. Look, I don't want you to think I'm not grateful, but I'd very much like to be alone.
Fine. You promise to give us a call if you need anything, eh?
Promise.
I'll ring you tomorrow.
Women obviously care about Gelschmidt, so they feel they're entitled to know what's happening. I don't think it could do any harm. The story's out anyhow.
Okay, let the papers go through unsensored. And tell the women I'll be around to talk to them soon.
Morning. Sorry I'm late.
How's Gelschmidt? You went to the hospital, didn't you?
Oh, she's pretty knocked around, but she seems in better spirits. You know, I wouldn't be surprised if she was glad this had happened.
You mean so she could stay?
God, they must have given her a terrible time in the East.
Yes, the hospital told me they found scars and old fractures dating back from her childhood. I doubt if she's known any real peace or freedom in her whole life.
Well, let's keep our fingers crossed. Mind you, if our women have anything to do with it, she'll get the keys to the city. I'll get back.
Seen the paper this morning?
Yes, just a quick look. They've certainly taken up Hannah's cause.
Let's hope it does her some good. It's amazing how quickly they got the story, though.
Yes, it is.
I mean, none of the women made the call, so I suppose it must have been an officer.
And you think perhaps it was me?
I know you well enough to know how much you care, Meg. If I were to ask you outright...
No, well, don't. The department would hold you responsible if they found out the security leak had come from one of the staff, wouldn't they?
Oh, yes, they'd be looking for blood.
Yes, well, I won't be saying anything. I think it's best the department just keep on guessing.
I was a bit slow off the mark, otherwise I'd have made the call myself. Still, Hannah's getting the help she needs.
Yes, and that's all that matters, isn't it?
There's not much time, Cass.
Not much time.
Yes, you must hurry. Bobby's going to kill you. Kill you today. She's evil, Cass. You know that, don't you?
She's evil. Bobby's going to kill me.
Not just you, Cass. Everybody. All your mates.
Gotta stop her.
That's it, Cass. You have to kill Bobby before she kills you and your mates. This is your last chance, Cass. You must do it today. You must kill. Today.
I must do it today. I must kill today.
And so far, over 12,000 signatures have been sent to the Department of Immigration. Apart from all the people who wrote to the dispatch itself.
Oh, that's great, Mrs. Reynolds. But is it going to help Hannah?
Well, her application for residency is being heard tomorrow. Now, we can't be certain of the outcome. But there's every chance that she could be free in a day or so.
Oh, that'd be fantastic.
Terrific.
Hi, I've missed something.
It's Hannah. Cass, Mrs. Reynolds reckons they're going to keep her here.
Yeah? Oh, I reckon that petition did the tickle after all.
Well, it was one of many.
Well, there's another one to come, Mrs. Reynolds. A few people were a bit late in signing, but we caught up with them.
I'll see that it's forwarded. Oh, you'll be happy to know that an old friend at Barnhurst's also been supporting Hannah's cause. Well, I won't keep you any longer.
Well, come on, back to work, ladies. And if you do half as good a job as you did for Goldschmidt, I'm sure we'll all be happy.
Oh. If I'm not mistaken, I think Perfer's just paid us a compliment.
Hey, how about B, huh? Wouldn't you know she'd get the ball rolling?
Yeah, she'll have more sign up at Barnhurst.
You really think the government's going to listen to a bunch of crims? Don't make me laugh.
Shut up, Fred.
Can't face facts, can you? They chuck us in here and forget we exist.
Oh, cut it out, will you?
Get stuffed, Porky.
That's enough, Keen.
Yeah, for you maybe, not for me. We're going to rot behind bars and no one gives us stuff. But some Hun comes into the country illegally, can't even speak the language, and suddenly you're all bucking for the Nobel Peace Prize. Well, I don't care where they send her. As long as it's not here.
Whilst my immediate interest lies in manipulating a passive personality to murder a best friend, the other possibilities are endless. Total rehabilitation of recidivist criminals is possible. Also, many far-reaching military possibilities. Pacifists could be programmed to kill. And in the case of...
Hi. Am I interrupting?
Not really. I was just sitting here feeling sorry for myself.
Oh, steady. I'm not getting the work done today.
I wish I could get some work done.
Problems?
I've hit a brick wall, Anne. Phyllis Hunt has reverted to type. She's shown strong antisocial behaviour on the last two visits. I really don't think there's much point in my seeing her again.
Oh, I'm sorry, John. I thought everything was going so well.
Parker's a volcano. She's bottling up so much violence. I don't think I can control it. Maybe I should just give it up.
This from the man who always gets results.
Ah, not always. I won't say I'm not disappointed, but that's not what really matters. I just I just feel that I've let the women down.
Oh, that's not true. What about Pixie?
Pixie. Lovable, loopy Pixie. My only success. A real triumph.
You're just feeling down. You expect too much of yourself.
You're so good for me, Anne. I hope... Ah, what the hell. Come on. I'm going to buy you the best lunch you've ever had in your life.
Well, can you deliver it to my office? I've got lashings of paperwork.
I've got to get out of this place, Anne. I need a change of scenery. Please don't turn me down.
All right, but you're completely mad.
I know. Must be love.
Brian, one for you.
Oh, thank you.
Here you are, Mason.
Oh.
That's it, ladies.
Well, I hope it's not that bridal catalogue I sent away for. We won't be needing it now.
Oh, jeez, I thought I might have heard from Dad by now. It's been a couple of weeks.
Well, don't worry, Cass. Maybe Charlie will write to you. And if he doesn't, I'll write to you.
I knew it. I bloody knew it.
What's the matter?
This is from Scott.
Mm-hmm.
He said that Edmonds was kicked out of the Foxsmith Institute for unethical practice.
Well, come on, read the letter.
Yeah, let me... I don't know exactly how far he went, Judy, except that his field was mind control through hypnosis. The Institute felt that the way he was manipulating his patients was both illegal and immoral, so they gave him a chance to resign.
Mind control? That's science fiction stuff.
Science fact. Phyllis and Cass... They're being hypnotized where they think they're just having a friendly chat.
What do you reckon he's up to?
I don't know. Well, I'm sure Ann Reynolds doesn't know either, but it's bloody time that somebody found out.
How are you, Rick? Heard about Rachel's father?
I was just tired. It's been a heavy night. Phoned Rachel this morning. George is out of intensive care. Suppose that's a good sign.
Oh, it gives you a jolt, doesn't it? I mean, one minute you've got the whole world in front of you. And the next, some idiot runs you down.
And that bastard was so blind drunk he could hardly stand up, let alone drive.
At least they caught him. He won't be doing it again.
He'll be doing it again. I'll have charged him and he should do a stretch for culpable driving. I guarantee he doesn't.
You're joking. I'll throw the book at him, surely.
Maybe. Smart lawyer, just get him off with a good behaviour bond. Okay, so he loses his licence, but bastards like that just keep on driving anyway.
What does Rachel think of that little possibility?
Right now, all Rachel can think about is George.
Get it.
Staff room.
Yes. Yes, he is. Just a moment, please.
Hello. Yeah, right. No, love, look, just stay calm. I'll be right there, okay? Just stay calm. I've got to operate again. Rachel's starting to panic. Look, Meg, can
what I... What are we waiting for? I'll cover for
thanks.
You.
His speciality is hypnosis, Mrs. Reynolds. It's obvious. He's been hypnotizing Cass and Phyllis, and you can bet your bottom dollar he didn't say, may I?
Oh, Judy. This research program has been approved. Perhaps if Scott knew the circumstances.
Stop the circumstances. I've been watching Cass and Phyllis. They're different people. It's just not natural.
But Dr. Edmonds has told me himself that the program isn't working. He's thinking of leaving Wentworth.
Oh. Well, maybe he got what he wanted and is getting out while he can. Who knows?
We are talking about a man's reputation.
We are talking about two women who are having their brains messed with. Mind control. Now, he has no right to use any of us as guinea pigs.
All right, I'll look into it.
That's all I'm asking.
May I keep this for a while?
Yeah, I don't need it. Thanks.
Get me a number, will you? I want to speak to the director of the Foxsmith Institute.
How's he doing? I got here as fast as I could.
It's too late, Rick. He's dead. Pop's dead.
Wait for a while. I got a lot on my mind at the moment. I'm really worried about Cass.
Well, that's just what I want to talk to you about. I'm just worried sick about her. Look, I would have spoken to you about this before, but it seemed like lagging. I mean, she's my friend. She didn't mean to hurt me.
Hang on a minute there. Are you trying to tell me that Cass is the one that hurt you?
Oh, well, please don't be angry with her, Jude, but it was Cass who tried to kill me. She didn't mean to do it. I mean, heavens, when I spoke to her about it, she didn't even remember.
Pixie, are you absolutely sure of this?
Of course I am. Well, at first I thought I was going mad because, you see, she didn't know it was me. And then she said something, I'm not quite sure what, but she thought I was Bobby. And I didn't understand that, Jude, because Bobby is Cass's friend. And, well, why would Cass want to kill Bobby? It just doesn't make sense.
Yes, it makes a lot of sense. God, I hope we're not too late.
On subject number 3, Margaret Morris. This case is working better than expected. I must take all necessary steps to ensure I'm not held responsible for her dramatic personality reversal.
How'd you go with Rena?
Where's Bobby?
Trying to loo.
I think she's got a Japanese bladder.
Yeah, needed Dumbo to hold her hand.
Did Cass go with her?
What's wrong?
Answer me,
yes.
Quick! Now, you get a screw. We need help. We gotta stop Cass.
Jude?
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside. And things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines. The sun and rain are prisoners too. When morning comes around, last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known. Till I had to face the nightmare, awaken up alone. When morning comes around.